As they work further down into the ruins, conditions for the rescue teams are getting harder. Hang in there, the rescuer shouts. We will soon get you out.
People are trapped in very small spaces, and we can't use big machinery down there. We mostly dig with our hands.
Around the edges of the site, relatives of the missing have been waiting anxiously for news since the earthquake on Saturday morning that caused this entire complex to crumble in seconds, trapping hundreds as they slept. Wang Xingwei is looking for his father and younger brother. He believes rescuers have been looking in the wrong place and urges them to look again. Chen Yumei is looking for her three-month-old baby, who was being cared for by her sister. She still can't understand what happened.
It's the construction company's fault. Other buildings didn't collapse like this one.
Many are now saying the complex was poorly designed and poorly built. In the local Mandarin language, it's called a tofu building. Like the dish of bean curd, it has no structure. And when the ground shook, it simply toppled over.
Now exposed in the ruins, these are tin cans that had been used in place of concrete on at least several floors. And local media have also been focusing on how the building was altered, with the ground floor turned into commercial space that may have weakened it further. Of equal concern is how the authorities in this quake-prone area of Taiwan didn't prevent such alterations.
The local prosecutor's office are doing a full investigation and they have come here to collect evidence.
As that investigation ramps up, so the search of the building continues, with the likelihood of finding more bodies than survivors. Rob McBride, Al Jazeera, Tainan City, Taiwan.